G'day guys, thank you for calling 1-800-PWNTIME. This is Jay speaking, and today I'm going to be giving you guys a little bit of help in how to level really fast in Call of Duty Black Ops. I mean, there's probably a lot of you who are trying to get to that 15th or 14th prestige so you can start getting your gold guns and whatnot. I mean, me personally, that's what I'm doing. I'm in my 13th prestige now, and I'm really trying to pump this last prestige out. So I'm going to give you guys a little bit of tips, you know, some advice on how to level quicken. First of all, I'll talk about your creator class. I mean, I know people are going to probably troll about this, but put on those weapons that you know are overpowered, because you're going to get good scores, like your Famous, your AK-74U, and another thing, use Warlord and put two attachments on it, and I'll go back into that a little bit more later. It has to do with the accomplishments and achievements that you get for using it in the challenges section. So, as you can see, I've got your Famous, I've got my Law as a secondary, that way I can shoot down any aircrafts, which I get lots of points for. You can always just noob tube it. I mean, it's only got one bullet, so one missile, so I mean, it's a good option to have. And you've got your frags, typical, they're good for collaterals, you can get big multi-kills with them. Flashbangs is probably the most effective tactical grenade in my opinion. I like concussions are good, I use them a lot as well, but flash completely blinds the opponent, I think it's a lot better. And of course your C4s, they're a bit tricky to get used to, but once you do, you've got that real extra offensive step. When someone's hiding behind a barrier or up in a window and you can't get a shot, toss one up and yeah, you'll just clean them up. And as for your perks, this is basically up to you. The only one I will suggest is Warlord for this particular reason, and I'll show you now. If you go into your player card, challenges, attachments on your weapons, okay? So I'll be running red dot sight and extended mags. As they go up and get into the later stages of the progress completion, you start to get some big EXP burners. When you get to red dot sight marksman 6 and 7, you start getting 10,000k hits of experience. And the fact that you've got two attachments on helps a hell of a lot, believe me. And also, it might be a bit of a bore, but try stick with the one weapon for the prestige. I mean, for the whole prestige, I should say, because I mean, you are just trying to boost, well not boost, you're trying to level quick, so the more you stick with one gun, again, the more experience bonuses you're going to get. Stick with the assault rifle, so you'll be getting your assault rifle headshots, they'll go up, and once they get into the 6 and 7s of that stage, you'll be getting more, 10k hits, same with the kills, 10k hits, and I think it gets up to even 20k hits once you finish it off. But I mean, if you time that with like double EXP weapons, you will absolutely clean up. And again, you'll have these two going, the assault rifle, kills and headshots, but as well you'll have the Famous going. So, I mean, that's presuming you stick with the Famous, but I will be for this prestige personally, because then I can start getting my golden guns next prestige, and I'm happy camper, but, well, not a camper, probably the wrong term for the game, but you know what I mean. So, yeah, stick to the same gun, because you'll get this as well, popping out 10k hits when you get up there, and I mean, you add it up, if they all go off around the same time, which they tend to do, I mean, the EXP comes in really fast at the end of those prestige levels, and it helps out a lot. And stick to the same game mode. I mean, I know it can be a bit boring, but I mean, at the end of the day, if all you're trying to do is prestige, tough it out. I mean, you can prestige in pretty much a day or two, so you shouldn't get too bored of a weapon in that time. Just stick to it, just gun it out, and yeah, it's a pretty quick way to prestige. And probably another thing that I'd suggest, if you're not the best player too, with your killstreaks, keep them lower, even if you are a good player, because I mean, these will come off a lot. You'll get your spy plane, counter spy plane, care package. Like, you can almost get them each time you run if you're a decent enough player. And I mean, care package, you've got the ability to get gunship, dogs, chopper gunner, thunder. So it's actually a pretty valuable killstreak to have on. And as for these, they're good team perks, your spy plane and counter spy plane. So no one's going to complain about you running the low streaks. At the end of the day, it's all about your team and winning. And if everyone's working together and they've got a good even spread of kill streaks, I mean, you're going to go fairly good. So I just thought I'd drop this quick video to help you guys out, and it's what I'm doing personally, so give it a try and let me know what you think, guys. If you've got feedback on something else that might help, then let me know, and I'll be happy to put up some more videos to help you guys level. That's it for today, guys, but thank you for calling, and there'll be more videos real soon. See you later.